And how y'all doing? Friends, time let's see it. At your service. And believe it or not, this is being played right. I'm recording this one day after the previous one has been recorded and uploaded. So today is Thursday.
Please drink the sap from the basin.
Yes, I know. This will be uploaded Friday since I will be gone all day, so I won't have anything else to upload. I will activate my own drink. I'm tripping balls!
Now recite the blessing to ward off any harm the outsider may be carrying before he proceeds to the grove.
I bid you depart, agents of destruction, through the power of his divine will.
Leave our homes and bodies immediately. Live no longer in them, but pass over into places where you can harm no one.
In the name of his frondescence, I call his wrath upon you, so that wherever you may go, you bear it with you.
And diminishing from day to day, you may disappear, except when you serve the health and good purposes of mankind, may no trace of you be found.
All this, may he be so good as to grant us, who is to come to judge the living and the dead, and the world by his virtue.
Yes.
Soon, you will pass peacefully into sleep, outsider. And when you awake, you will witness his glory firsthand.
Sir, I think I'm tripping balls! I'm tripping balls again! And loading screen. Is this him? Is this Harold? Oh god, I can't run. Wait, am I over? Nah, we'll do it. I need some of that. That way. I got some stuff. Dude. No, because I was not out of it. Who's gonna have to wait? Oh. I don't really need this. Take care. I need that. I need a wrench. What's that? Oh, hey. Vodka. I've become addicted to vodka. Oh. Now I'm back to 60 health. This. I don't need death claw. There's some other stuff I dropped. Even all the other death claws. Alright, I might need it. I'm okay for that. I'm okay for that. I'm okay for that. Are we overcovered? No. Alright, good. Is there anything else? No, I don't think I did. Alright, let's go. Harold? Easy, you, my Harold.
Come around to where I can see.
It's Harold.
Glad to see you're finally awake. I can't believe they made you do that stupid ceremony. They listen when I talk, but they don't hear. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Neither have I. Well, I mean, I talked to Herbert. He kept growing around me. Maybe for calling him Herbert all the time. His name's really Bob. I think it's funny when I call him Herbert, though.
I understand, Harold. Harold, you don't sound good.
Well, see, Bob used to ride around on top of my head. Sunk his roots right in there, you know? Well, eventually he got bigger than me, and then I pretty much ended up inside. It was a long time ago. I tend to lose track. I was exploring some sort of a military base with some other people. I think it was called Mariposa.
Mariposa.
We were pretty deep inside and we found some weird vats of this nasty.
By the way, vats is that one goo. Like targeting system I use.
Right when we were about to leave, I think we were attacked. Yeah. Last thing I remember before blacking out was something knocking my friend into the stuff. You have no idea how glad I am to hear that. Or we're glad to hear that, me and Bob. I had you brought in here to ask a very simple favor. Would you please kill me?
He's suicidal.
Oh no. It wouldn't be murder. You'd be doing me a favor. You see, I've been stuck here for over 2 decades now. The only friends I've got are Bob and those weirdos out there who think I'm a god. Oh, no. They usually don't understand a word I say, but I make them. I've been feeling rather spread out lately. I think Bob's kind of shoved my insides around some.
You can kind of see where
it's on. It's hard to tell where everything is. Anyway, I believe Bob's carried some of my organs in. Of all the wastelanders I had to bump into, it has to be one with a conscience. Let's keep it an open invitation then. I don't want to wait until the next person visits. It could be years. Just. No. Herbert is the tree. Bob is his real name, but I called. But I'm still in here, too.
Yes, it's Harold.
What's left of me?
Harold.
The name's Harold.
Harold. But I don't want to destroy his heart. Whoa. He did his run. Kind of saw it. How do I not kill him? I don't want to kill Harold. I don't want to kill Harold. Oh, no. Hello.
This place is wonderful, isn't it?
Yes. Where's the... Oh, I got it. Good sir, I have
and
a problem.
And I'm telling you, You've got it all wrong. Why else would he have called for an outsider's assistance?
The outsider is here to deliver us from our enemies, to keep this place safely locked away from the wasteland, not to exploit us.
How can we preach about peace when all you want to do is keep his gift all to ourselves? That's not what he would want.
If we allow the spread of this miracle to continue, we're putting him in jeopardy. I can't allow that. I won't allow it.
Once again, my husband, we are at an impasse. I suggest we speak to the outsider.
I'm right here.
Agreed. Why else would the outsider have been allowed into the grove? Perhaps it's a test. Yes, that must be it.
I like how he just looks over and I like the mirror.
I know why you're here. And despite what my wife thinks, after all, he chose... Oh, he's testing you. He wants to see if your faith is strong by spinning these incredible... Don't worry. Yes, I've been pondering that riddle myself for some time now. The Great One's influence is growing, and soon it will break free of the confines of this seclusion. We can't allow Oasis to call attention to itself like that. It would be the end of him. If the same sap that you drank to purify yourself could be applied to his heart, it should stop. I can promise you, no harm would come to him. That's all I ask of you,
I will help him, because I love Harold!
I love Birch, but sometimes I think he doesn't see the spreading of his influence is not a curse. It's a great miracle. Of course we do. He yearns to share his miracles with the whole world.
No.
To give the gift of life back to the dead wasteland.
No.
It's upsetting him to no end, but Birch can't see the pain it's causing.
No, he wants to die.
But now that you're here, I have a feeling the winds are about to change.
No, he wants to die.
I heard what my husband wanted you to do. The same person that created the sap also created this liniment. If you could, instead of centuries, the wasteland will become green in mere decades. Just a
So wait, could I do both? Where's his heart?
This place is wonderful, isn't it?
I do both. Alright, so where is it? This way.
Cast aside your bits of technology and move
everything. I believe it's here. Yeah, this is a cage. Ooh, I need a key. Oh. I need a key. Yeah, I need the key. Father Birch! Father Birch! I need a key! Father Birch! Father Birch! That's gonna get annoying. Father Birch! I need a key! Father Birch!
Branch tender cypress act.
Are you Father Birch?
Well,
yes.
Yes, outsider. What? Just like a cancer would infest our bodies, you'd do well to be cautious. I'm afraid the water still bears the mark of man's greed. It's his reminder of what we want. Perhaps one day, he will see fit to lift this punishment. But I fear we have...
I need a key.
Have no...
Hello, outsider. It's very nice to see you. You have questions for me? If the Great One knows you to be worthy of his grace, he will... The Great One has not yet allowed us entry below ground. The liniment was made by Bloom Seer Poplar. Her knowledge of his gifts and how they can be used to help the entrance. May the sap of his wisdom.
Stephen Harold.
It's amazing that people trust you enough not to attack
me. Uh-oh. Buff out. That's what was making me able to carry all that. Good. See, here's one of his arms, and then there's the other. How you doing, Harold?
Look, Herbert, he's back. Okay. I was once a man, a long time ago, named Harold.
Yes, I got
something
that.
Something in me changed, and a weird little tree,
and the tree got
started growing. Right out of my head.
Yes.
It kept getting bigger until I ended up stuck inside.
Yes.
When people would ask about it, I decided to name it Bob. You know, like a friend or something.
Yes.
Sometimes I call him Herbert. Instead of Bob, because I get bored and I think it's funny. So, long story short, call me Harold.
Yes.
Yeah. I think the best way for you to get down there would be to get the key. The one those loonies call Cypress. There's supposed to be some. Sometimes I feel stuff tickling me, but I think that's just Bob getting back at me for all the times I.
Watch,
call
I'll go down, I'll be the farmer.
I've been literally rooted to this spot, thanks to Bob, for maybe 20 or 30 years. I can't even remember anymore.
Okay.
Can you imagine being stuck in one place?
Nah, crap. Hold up, I got it, guys. There we go. Got it.
For that long, not being able to eat or to read or to sleep or anything. In the meantime, I have these tree minders bothering me every day about things I don't even care about. I can't stand it anymore! I've tried to stay happy, really. I have. Gloomseer Poplar thinks I'll live for hundreds of years, maybe even more. Can you imagine that? When I saw you coming towards the way... I'm telling you, it is possible. I swear, I think it's making Bob kinda jump. It's kinda embarrassing, really. Once a year, Bob decides he's gonna go ahead and start growing these weird pods filled with tiny seeds. Well, all it takes is a good wind and the seeds just fly everywhere. I call them Herbert seeds. He hates that. Don't worry, Herbert. He'll be back.
Okay, bye. So I got seeds, like, something like that. Anyways, last loads. I'm going to get a coke. I'll be right back. Dog meat. Or good boy. Good boy, dog meat. How's it going, dog meat? Alright, so we've got a miniature purse. No, that's my purse.
This place is wonderful, isn't it? Yes. What can I do? I think this place would be lost. There's no telling what fate may have befallen the Great One if someone like the godless raiders had gotten here.
Oh, wait, found him. Cypress, I need the key.
This place is wonderful. Ah, outsider, so nice to see you again. Sure. I wish they wouldn't argue so much. It makes everyone uncomfortable.
I would be too, trust me. So how do you end up here?
I was an outsider like yourself, wandering the world aimlessly, wasting my life trying to seek my fortune. When my eyes beheld the splendor of Oasis, I knew I'd found a holy place. Tree Father Birch allowed me to stay, and I've been here ever since.
That's a good story.
May the sap.
Yes. I got the key. I kind of want to stop it, just so this place is like more magical. But I definitely do not want to kill him. Why would I kill Harold? I don't want to kill Harold. I have to kill Harold, don't I? I don't want to kill Harold. Probably, I don't want to go ill, but that really is what I have to do. His heart. Oh, okay, that's a Merle. That's not what I was turning to. I was turning to. That's a dead Merle. That's a Merle. That's a dead Merle. Ugh. That's a swimming Merloc, but I want to look at the thing about it. No, that's not what I want. What? Yeah, that's what I want to look at. That ain't good. This one. Oh, I didn't see that one. Now. Oh. Ow. What was that? Oh, wait. Was that you? Yeah, that's you. What the? Alright, so, dog meat's taking care of that. I'm gonna just aim for you. Either might be AR. Let's see, Yeah. Anyway. Oh, my God. I like how he's just, like, he's swimming, but he's not actually, like, attacking him like he normally does. Stop shooting dog meat. I think once the dog meat skipped out right there. Apparently he's dead. Oh, the water stops it. So wait, I can't fire more. Oh, that would make sense. That would make sense. I'm hunting here in the wild. But when you need someone to kill in the water, you need an Autox. Actually, I just realized you can't kill anything while underwater. I'm dying. So where's his heart? I'm looking for it. Oh, you're a bad judge. What? That was easy. Wow. Oh my God, there's Merloc eggs everywhere. Whoa! Don't you ever sneak up on me, you sneaky bastard. See, it kind of see how it the band was different. It reloaded itself. Hi. Oh wait, it is. Is his heart above here? No, it's not. Why are they getting 6 EXP? Oh, is this to his heart? Something chambers. I'm guessing this leads to his heart, and he wants me to kill him. I don't really want to. I don't really want to kill Harold. Is it a lawnmower? Why? Let's go. This way. Wait. This is hard. I see trees. That's crazy. Ow! What the? That was a grenade. Kept him alive, and I didn't need to destroy his heart. I should have just done that one because, well, I guess now the wasteland's gonna look a lot more green. Which I guess is a good thing. Also, yes, I'm going to do this again. Also, I have my kitten boy light on. Bip time! Excuse me. This way? No. Got some interesting stuff. Ah! Jesus. Yes, I am wearing the uniform normally worn by Colonel Adams. But he's dead now. And that's also why I have his pistol. Laser pistol, that is. Hi. Oh. For a second there, I thought it was like a Murloc King, like, sitting down. This video has been going on for a while. So once I complete the mission, it's a day of tomorrow. This has happened to me before, and I just think it's just hilarious. If the Murlocs die in water, their bodies just spend it. Oh, he was in his run. Actually, I've tried to run already, but I don't mind. Five speed, you're running the normal still. I could hug you, but actually I could hug you. Give me a hug, man! Blah. And we get one.
Into each life some rain. But too much is falling in mine.
You know what? I want all of you to, well, into if you're watching the video, I want you to take a photo of me right now, just sitting on some.
But someday the sun will shine.
Take a photo right now, sitting on the phone. That's what I look like when I'm actually sitting on my phone. Alright, let's go. This way.
But when I think of you, another
can we chop the Herald again?
Into each life some rain must fall. But too much is
if you don't know what he's wearing a Vault 87 jumpsuit. That's where it came from.
Into each life some rain.
You've done a great deed this day, my. The gifts, the great. In your short visit here, I can see you've learned my good luck in all.
Yes.
Some tears must fall.
Errol, are you doing better
now?
Yes.
So, it looks like you decided to do things. So, should we give them another? Okay. Wave bye-bye, Bob. Oh, come on. Move a branch at least. Oh, wave.
Rain has got to fall.
But well, guys, that is Oasis. My good friend Harold. Oh, my God, Harold. I could hug him. I hug out the dead tree.
Some tears gotta fall.
Call him Harold. If I ever get home, I'm going to call that tree. If the tree looks like Harold, I'm going to name him Harold.
Some folks can.
Anyways, that's going to do it for this video. And I had a good plan.
But when I think
I'm
going to
turn this radio off so you can hear me. There you go. Alright, so, my plan for the next episode. After I sit on my throne and sit like a mouse. Anyways, yes, how you doing, Dummy? Let me just ponder about the way of life. Anyways, next video, I have a good plan. I have a plan to, there's a DLC I have called Mothership Zeta. And it has, you guessed it, a mothership. So I'm gonna look for that next time, but for now, this is it. Prince Time was signing out.